In the lecture on ket notation, we discussed three ways to represent quantum states: column vectors with complex coefficients, kets themselves, and the geometric representation, which uses the Bloch sphere. Each one of these has their own little advantages and disadvantages, which we're going to see in the course of these videos. First, let's take a look at some of the advantages of ket notation. So here's ket notation. It's very nice for sparse states, that is to say states which don't have that many non-zero entries in some basis. Take, for example, this state here, which I'll call psi along with most other states. It's got two non-zero terms. There's a 1 over root 2 term for the component in 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and a 1 over root 2 term for the all ones as well. This would be very cumbersome to write out in terms of a full vector, because that would require 2 to the 5 or 32 entries. But here you can do it very compactly. Now, if you don't have a compact description for the state like this, if you just have some arbitrary coefficients, it can be very painstaking and time-consuming to write out something like this. Beta times 0, 1, plus gamma times 1, 0, plus delta times 1, 1. Here you'd be better off to use something more like a column vector. Alpha, beta, gamma, delta. And at some other times, especially if you're considering operations, transformations on the set of states, it can be beneficial to consider the Bloch sphere, where you have the reference state 0, some other states 1, plus and minus, like so.